You know, much a debate really happening ever since that marathon meeting concluded last evening, or late last night, I should say. Would you say it was a little inconclusive? Because all that we've seen is various committees being formed. We don't know what's going to constitute of these committees. No decision per se has been taken.
I think the big message out of the meeting was that there is no breakdown in communication and a consensus is being worked out. I think that's the most positive part of it, because the general sense one got from media reports and the kind of conversations that were happening in public was that it could lead to a situation where communication breakdown happens and the economy would get into a bit of a tizzy because of that. So obviously that hasn't happened. The fact that it went on for so long is an indication of the fact that there is an effort being made on both sides. Respect and restraint is being shown to arrive at some consensus. In terms of the outcomes of the meeting, I think broadly both sides have in some ways reconciled to each other's positions. And it's also, I think, only appropriate that no decisions are taken at the board level in such critical issues, but it's not a knee-jerk reaction, and some thought and advice is given. I think the biggest thing out of the meeting also emerged was that there was no diktat from the board. I think that it's, RBI is not a listed company, so it can't be board driven, and board has stuck to being advisory in its thing. It advises the governor, and then the governor can go ahead and do the implementation. I personally have been saying this, very happy that there is at least a board that one knows of, and it is not a dormant and a docile board, but an active board, and that will help the RBI as well as the government. In terms of what the decisions were taken, I think you're right, in some way no conclusive decisions, but let's say take the case of the reserves, the surplus issue being discussed. I mean, it was already there in the setup that Marigam committee had recommended after 3 years review it. It'll go up for a review. So I think that's now the whole institutional mechanism has been strengthened. And this debate whether RBI, the central bank, is overcapitalized or not, anyway, was being examined every 3 years. So that has expired. The Marigam committee recommendations do suggest that. So I think that going forward is going to set up a mechanism, an institutional practice, whereby every 3 years it will be assessed and a view taken. Last 3 years, the entire surplus have been transferred based on recommendation of the committee. So going forward, that can again be done in a more systematic manner. So I think it furthers the whole issue of institutionalization of the Reserve Bank decision making. With regard to PCA, I think there is, the news reports do suggest that
okay, fair point. I've got your initial remarks pretty much on every aspect, and thank you for outlining it so brilliantly, Mr. Drabu. My immediate follow-up question is that the impression which the finance ministry gave was that, okay, RBI was not doing enough to really address the liquidity issue. They need to take bold steps and they need to do something to really increase the liquidity flow. Now, the fact that nothing has come out and a committee is being made to address an issue like liquidity, which is need of the hour, that just confuses me.
Let me look at it this way. First of all, an OMO was done and has been going round rounds. My own sense of it, and I'm not in the market, but my sense of it is that liquidity is not as tight as it was in September. Some numbers have come, the bank financing of NBFCs has gone up from 1% to 7%. Now, that's a sharp jump. I mean, I think is there enough data to suggest that there's a liquidity problem? A. Then B, is the liquidity problem sectoral, related only to NBFCs, or is it a general problem? Now, depending on what the data shows, and RBI should have probably looked at this data much more closely, and I'm sure they do, put to the board as well. Is it based on that data a decision was not taken? Now, again, if liquidity, it turns out, is a generic liquidity problem, not a sectoral problem, then RBI has enough instruments to do that. I mean, you can address it through yesterday also, you can do it through a CRR cut, which doesn't need all these kinds of complicated thinking. So the real issue is that is there a genuine liquidity crunch today? I'm not using the word crisis. from a report that seems to have come yesterday from Credit Suisse is that actually it has gone up since September and the system is working. So is there a need for a sectoral intervention at this stage is something that I would debate. If that is decided either way, a callback can be taken. There are enough instruments for RBI to infuse liquidity in the system. And of yesterday also, I believe OMOs were done in the setup.